Everyone, welcome to my TechnoEd learning channel. Today I'll be explaining you the overview of an organized Google Classroom. So you can see here, I have my Google Classrooms here. I'll go to one of this classroom where 65 students have joined. So I'll go here. So you can see here the various announcements that are made. Okay, from the new announcements at the top and the old announcements at the bottom. There are various announcements are made from the time the Google Classroom is created. Okay. Then, since there are no upcoming events here, so this is empty, no work due soon. If the deadline is attached, the further deadline are attached to a particular assignment or any quiz, it will be shown here. Now, when I go to classwork, so you can see here, the environmental engineering subject is organized into different topics. This becomes very easy for students to access. First is the environmental engineering notes. So you have notes, then syllabus and question papers, then related to mini project, related to visit to the sewage treatment plant, related to experiments, and then the syllabus according to its modules are then made into different topics. So you can see here, module 6. Module 4, 5, module 2, 3, and module 1. Also inside it, if you can see, when I say EE2 notes, so it has all the notes. View material you can do, or you can see here. Okay, design notes. This is a copy of my book that I have attached. So this way, you can attach your scanned copy also. Then syllabus of the subject, okay, then question bank, and again the question papers, these are also attached. Okay, similarly mini project, the format of mini project for us attached for students, then submission of mini project. So here you can see 59 have turned, that is 59 have submitted and 6 assigned but not yet submitted. And the rubrics is also given. Okay. Similarly, visit to sewage treatment plant, experiment, these are the videos of virtual lab, that is the links of the virtual lab which are attached. Similarly, various videos and the NPTEL videos related to my experiments. Then module wise, that is module 6, then the course outcome 4 which comes under this module 6, then different notes in the form of PowerPoint presentations. Assignment 4, Viva in the form of short answer questions on assignment 4, quiz, and there is one case study attached to that particular topic, the video. It is a link of a YouTube video. Okay, similarly here also, for every start of the module, it starts with the course outcome, the related notes, then assignment, Viva on that assignment, and quiz on that particular module. So this is how it is organized. You can see. Okay. Now I'll show you how the grading is done. So for example, since the deadline for submission of mini project was over, I'll go here to submission of EE2 mini project. Okay. And I'll go to this edit. See here you can see the rubrics that is attached to this mini project. Total 5 points are there for mini project, and these are divided into one, that is topic selection, another 1 mark for content, another 1 mark for timely submission, and 2 marks for questions on your mini project. So this is how the grading, that is the rubrics, is made for the total 5 marks of for their mini project. Okay. Then we'll go to the projects here. You can see here how many people have submitted on time, that is turned in, how many people have turned in late. Okay, so you can see here all the projects of the students. Okay, so now if I want to start with the grading, click on one of the project. So as you click here, you can see their copy, and here it is already shown that it is turned in and done late. Okay, so that is a late submission. Now here it is showing me it is total 22 pages of report. Now I can from here I can select a particular student name whose project I am going to assess, or else with this arrow tab you can navigate to the next student project. The next student's project is now showing. The next, see the name also here you can see. It is turned in on time, and if not turned in on time, it shows late. Okay, so this is how I can use the arrow tab to navigate to different files uploaded by the students. So I don't need to go to that files again and open it separately. Okay, so this is how you can do it. Now you can assess the mini project or any PDF file or assignments. Okay, and if I want to attach a comment, see if I feel that there is a particular problem in a particular area or a mistake, I'll say. Okay, for example, I feel this is wrong. So what I can do is add comment. I can drag like this and add some. This seems wrong. Something like that. And then comment. Okay, this I can do, but it becomes very tedious to go through each page and comment on each page. So a very easy thing is comment bank. Click on this and add a comment, add to bank. So this is a comment bank, a total comment for a particular PDF, a particular assignment or a particular project can be written here and can be added. So it becomes a common comment, summary of all the comments. Okay, and you can add that. Okay, now here it is grading. So now I have to grade. It is total 5 points. Topic selection, if I feel the topic is good, I'll give it 1. If I feel the content is good, I'll give it 1. But it has he did not submit it on time. It was not timely submission, so I'll give it 0. And questions, he got 1 mark out of 2. So questions, in the questions asked, he got 1 mark, so I'll give 1. Okay, now you can return this with the grade to the students. Now if I go to my grade work, okay, see, now if I go to grade, here I can see all my students who have joined the classroom. Here I can see all the work that is being assigned to them. Viva on visit, Viva on assignment, Viva on assignment, submission of EE2 project, okay, submission of EE2 visit report, quiz, everything you can see here. I'll just drag you and show. Every work that is being given to student can be seen here. Missing means they have not attempted yet. Okay. Now, using this tab, I'll move. Since it was this person, this student for which I have assigned marks, so I'll go here on his mini project. See, this is submission of mini project. Okay. And it thus already shows me 3 marks. So whatever grades I have given the student on his work, it is directly reflected in the grade. And done late, it is also shown it is not timely submitted. So I can assess all my assignments, all my project work, all the files that are submitted by the students, and those grades which I give them on their files will be ultimately reflected over here. So it reduces a lot of my work. So this is an easy way to grade students on their particular work. Okay, see, when I go to people, I can see all the students who have joined classwork and stream. So this is how you can organize your Google Classroom and you can give grades to students on their work. Thank you so much.